Yeah, my session is going to be called Who Even Reads Newsletters, right? So I'm sorry, Abhishek, because frankly, I know you're clearly a big fan of newsletters, but before I started on this journey, I was not, right? So how does this thing work? Yeah. So I've signed up for scores of newsletters in my life, right? I'm a journalist. I've been in the media for like 11, 12 years now. And throughout, like, since when I've had an email ID and I've discovered that you can sign up to newsletters and it is somewhat of a, it's considered a good thing, or it's considered intellectual or smart to be like signing up to newsletters. I've been signing up to like a bunch of newsletters in my life, and most of them go into trash, right? They're there in my this thing. I'm even afraid, like, you know, I'm like, okay, maybe next week or maybe tomorrow I will actually like click on that newsletter, open it and read that entire thing. And therefore I don't even mark it spam. I just like, you know, like select it and put it to trash and hope that the next day it again comes back to the inbox. And for some reason it does. And for me, it's difficult because like, I mean, I subscribe to Rohan's Political Fix, which I open once in a while, right? Then I subscribe to a bunch of like long read stuff because I think I'm the kind of person who should be reading long form, right? Except I never have the time. I never have the time to read long form. I never have the time to sort of, you know, go in and like deep dive into seven different opinions that people have on, and all of them are like, you know, 1,500, 2,000, 5,000 words long. And I really, you know, the kind of newsletters that I realized that I would open later on, I mean, quite recently, in fact, because we started doing like, we started taking newsletters more seriously. And, you know, there was so much talk of like, yeah, you need to do newsletter and that's the only way to like succeed and stuff like that. So I started like, subscribing to like more and more newsletters, right? I signed up to more and more newsletters and I realized that most of them I wouldn't read unless I needed to like open something and like see something specific. Like, you know, how are they doing something? Or, you know, how is it that they're summarizing something? How is it that they're presenting something? What is the design? Like, how does it look on mobile versus how does it look on desktop? Right? If I had those questions, then I would open a newsletter. But as a, would I do it for like pleasure? Right? Most of the time, no. Until I found some fun newsletters about like, you know, entertainment or like queer movies and stuff like that. Like, otherwise I would never like sort of actually open a newsletter and read the entire thing in my life. So for me, I was a non-believer. Maybe I am not a believer yet. I don't know. Right. So when we said, as I was saying earlier, just a little bit about News Minute's journey. TNM, the News Minute, so TNM, has been around since 2014. We are a digital native, we are mobile first, and yes, it's been like, you know, interesting sort of being out there and covering South India, which pretty much not many people do in English, right? I mean, yes, there are organizations in Tamil and Malayalam and Kannada and Telugu which cover news from South India quite well. However, in English, I mean, we have national media who are living in these Delhi and Bombay bubbles, and they don't care like what happens outside of those Delhi and Bombay bubbles. When TNM started, we realized that this was our USP, and people responded to that, right? So that's what we've been on. That's the journey that we've been on. That is our USP. We cover the South. We've been thinking about membership for a while, as most media organizations, or especially most digital media organizations, which have realized that, you know, reader revenue is very important. So we've been thinking about membership for a while. I was part of a Google and Columbia fellowship last year. So the project that I went with was also our membership program. And we've always wanted to like sort of focus on our NRI audience for our membership, right? So we wanted to say that, you know, these are the people that we want to go to and ask them to like support us. And we've never wanted to go behind a paywall. We've never said that, you know, we want to go behind a paywall. One reason is because, I mean, look at the country that we are in. Look at the place that we are in. There is so much like fake news, so much misinformation and disinformation, and so many people like believing whatever they see on WhatsApp. And there's so much crap out there, right? So people who do put out actual news and do fact-checked news, ground reporting, we should be available for people who want to read us. And that was one reason we've decided not to go behind a paywall. However, we do want reader revenue, like pretty much everyone else, right? And we do know that readers want to support us. There are many people who want to support independent media, many people who want to support PNM. So membership is the way we've chosen to go. We've you know, been working on it for a while. However, it was not the plan to start as suddenly as we did in April this year, end of April, in May this year. That was purely the pandemic, right? The pandemic hit and it hit the entire media industry and especially people like us, right? Like smaller media organizations, web media organizations, our advertising revenue like crashed. We needed to do something fast. We needed to do something to survive. And we saw like news of huge legacy media organizations like firing people, which was a shock to us because if someone as small as us can take that decision to sort of say we're going to like, you know, do our best to make sure that that doesn't happen, then you see legacy media doing that and you're like, okay, like, you know, what is it that they're doing wrong? But yeah, so we decided that we needed to do something like quickly. We got an email from our CEO to tell all of us that, you know, we know that this is happening in the media industry in India, but it's not going to happen to us. Like, none of you are going to get fired, right? Or none of you are going to have to take a pay cut. We may not have like appraisals for a bit, but that's okay. So that was the message to the employees. And so we regrouped and we said, okay, we're going to start a membership program for our India readers, which of course is a it's a game at scale, right? In India, you can't make money unless you have like a lot of members. But we still decided to sort of take the plunge and we went to our readers and we said, we don't have everything ready. We were honest about that. We don't have everything ready, right? We want to give you a bunch of things, but we don't have them ready. What we will give you right now is a weekly newsletter. And once we have everything else ready, and for that, we need your help, right? We need some money to be able to come in and some time to be able to get all of these things ready. Then you get all the other benefits. So that's what we went in with and people responded greatly. And yeah, so that was the first, the second newsletter of TNM. The first newsletter has been around since I don't know when. That's Daily Wrap. We send it out to, it's a free newsletter that goes out to whoever signs up. And that goes out, it's just a brief, it's a curation of like, you know, stories that we've done through the day that might be of interest to our readers. So the newsletter, the first membership newsletter was Here's the Thing. That's what we started. I'll come to like what we do with that in a bit. So for me, like, you know, when we decided to do this and when we decided that, okay, the newsletter is the one thing that we can give our members, right? And that's when like the non-believer in me had to be like challenged and say, okay, you got to do this now, right? You've got to do this now and let's see what's the best we can do with it, right? So for me, the personal challenge is like, how do I make a person who's like me, right? Who is probably wants to look smart and intellectual and whatever, wants to believe that, you know, they're brainy enough to like subscribe to a bunch of like intellectual things. But when it actually comes down to reality, they don't have the time, right? They don't have the concentration. They are distracted by 100 things happening in life and they're living in the middle of a pandemic, right? How do I make that person open my newsletter? So that is my personal challenge as I went into this. And one thing is to make them open that newsletter once. And then the next challenge is to make them do it regularly. How do I make them open that newsletter regularly? Right. So those are my challenges. So TNM's newsletter, we have the Daily Wrap, which is free for anyone who wants to sign up. Then the first newsletter that we started for our members, India members, Here's the Thing. And this is going out to members in India and our NRI members, the TNM Roots program, which is our NRI membership program. So Here's the Thing is more analysis. It's more non-rhetorical opinion. And it has a bunch of modules, right? Like basically we have a main piece in the newsletter every week, which is like, you know, a take on something, but not a hot take. We try very hard to avoid like rhetorical, like, you know, hot Twitter take type stuff and try and give like, you know, some information or some sort of depth to the piece. We also try and get in like expert voices once in a while. We in the newsletter also has ICYMI, and in case you missed it, a story of, I mean, basically five stories from across the web, right? It doesn't have to be TNM. We, whatever, I mean, Scroll has published something that is interesting. We put that in there. If, you know, Wire has something or Hindustan Times has something, we just like, you know, say, okay, these are the five stories that the person curating the newsletter, mostly me, thinks that, you know, you should probably read this week if you have the time. So we put that together. And because we are doing membership and not subscription, and I want to like make that distinction very clear. A lot of people say they are doing membership and they're actually doing subscription. But we are doing membership, right? Membership is about saying that, you know, you become a part of our community, you become a part of our journey, and you actually, like, you know, are more invested than just saying, like, Times of India or a Hindu, hey, I give you money, I throw a newspaper at you. No, that's not the relationship that we want with our members, right? So one of the things that we are doing is sort of asking members to, you know, send in their recommendation to the rest of the community for what do they think that they should like read or watch or, you know, cook this week. So we're still in the beginning stages, I would say. So it's still a bit of a, you know, I have to reach out to members from the community. It's not like, you know, they're still coming to me with like a lot of like voluntary. Sometimes they do, but like not all the time. And we also decided that this is a place where we will tell people, like, you know, who are the people who are working at TNM. So here's the thing, also like sort of has a column, a little column where one of our colleagues is featured every week. And it's, one is, I think most people do want to know, right? Who is it that is doing that work, right? And who are these people beyond that Twitter handle or beyond that byline? Like, who is this person? So to see that from somebody else's eyes, like see that like a small informal write-up about that person from someone else, as I think, interesting. And I think readers also do enjoy that. I do see that like a lot of people do go check out their Twitter profiles when we write about somebody and stuff like that. And secondly, it's a great morale boost for my own team, right? Like for our people, it's great to say that, you know, I'm getting recognized for the work that I do and for the person that I am. And it's great. Like, I mean, that is extremely important for any organization, especially in the middle of a pandemic. Right. So the third one, TNM Briefs, it goes out only to our TNM Roots members. And like I was telling Abhishek earlier, the second edition of that newsletter went out last night. And the fourth one is Mosaic. We've only had one edition go out. It's only for TNM Roots members. TNM Briefs is, again, it's basically a curated thing of like saying, if I wake up in the morning and I'm living in a different time zone, what happened in South India back then, right? In those 12 hours that I was sleeping. What happened in South India? What do I need to like sort of catch up on without having to go to like 100 different sources or having to depend on like WhatsApp forwards and stuff like that? So that is the aim of TNM Briefs. And Mosaic is a fortnightly culture and arts roundup that we are sending out to NRI members again, because they want to know like what is happening in India. And it's not always possible to sort of keep in touch with all of it in like one place. It's difficult to sort of say, who am I going to and how am I going to get this information? So these are the newsletters that we have. The challenges, we struggle just like everyone else. I frankly don't think anyone has like figured out newsletters so well that, you know, every issue has a great open rate or anything of that sort, right? We all struggle. We all like sort of try to make sure that every issue of the newsletter has something of interest and, you know, it's sent out at the right time, on the right day, when most people will open. And then you're thinking about like, you know, is it a holiday? Is it because it's a holiday that a lot of people are not opening it? Or is something else happening? Is there like something else happening in the news wheel because of which nobody's like interested in it? Or, you know, is it a subject that is that so many people are talking about? Like, for instance, is it Pride Month? And is everybody talking about Pride Month because of which my newsletter is like ending up in spam? So all of these things are struggles, all of these are challenges, but it's crucial for our success because we have a membership model, as I said. Like, newsletters are crucial for our success, and how much ever of a non-believer I was, like, now I am like, oh, bring this on, like, this is a challenge and I'm going to do this, right? And we take heart in knowing that literally no one has figured it out. Like, I don't know. I mean, maybe there are people who have like 100% open rates or 80% open rates or whatever. You know, we are not those people for sure. We experiment and we fail fast, right? So it's not like, you know, we are doing the same thing and we know that it's not working, but we're still going to like continue doing this forever. No, I mean, we know something is not working, then change it, right? a particular time is not working, change it. Let's figure out like what is it that is that made my newsletter have an open rate of 40% last week, but it's only like 20% this week. So what is the difference between that and this? Is it the subject? Is it something else that is technical, right? So all of those things. So we just like keep experimenting and we fail fast and like move on to the next thing in case it's not working. So the milestones, Abhishek wanted me to talk about milestones. What are the milestones? I don't have specific milestones. This is, I'm new to this journey, right? So the day we realized our paid newsletter was getting forwarded was a great day for me, right? So we're like, okay, this newsletter is only for members. Huh? Only members can like open this. And then I'm looking at the open rates and I'm like, okay, there is something, like I look at the data and I'm like, there are a lot of people that I didn't send the newsletter to who are opening it. And I'm like, hey, that's great. Right? Because that means that there is desirability. That means that somebody who has paid for the newsletter wants their friends to read it or, you know, thinks that there is something of value to like forward this to somebody else. And that's great, right? Even if that other person is not paying for it, the fact that there is desirability is great for me. Some weeks we hit a 40% open rate and I'm like, wow, yeah, like, great. I've earned my extra cake for this week, right? Then the greatest thing is like feedback. Right? When readers write back with their thoughts and they say, you know, this is something that I didn't think about. You know, thanks for telling me this. And then I want to like implement this. Or even to say, you know, you wrote about all of these things, but you missed out a big thing. This is a perspective that you didn't bring in. That's great. That's feedback. Right. And I live for feedback. Whenever anybody like sends in long emails, and there are some people who do, right. And I'm always grateful to them. People who send in like a 500 word, 600 word, 700 word email in response to a 1,000 word newsletter. I mean, I love those guys, right? So when that happens, you know that, you know, you're reaching out to people in a meaningful way. It's not something that they're just going to, you know, look at, open and like forget about tomorrow, but they put some thought into it and they wanted to respond to you for some reason. And that's great, right? Another is when someone signs up because they know what's in a particular issue, right? So we've had somebody write about it and we like sort of promote on social. And when we promote on social, somebody says, hey, how can I read this thing? And we tell them, you know, you have to become a member to be able to read this. And then they said, yeah, okay, this is worth it. This is worth my money, right? And then they sign up to become a member. And that's a great milestone for me. Biggest milestone, a couple of days back, finally, my sister who lives in Dublin decided that she would sign up for our membership program because I sent her the first issue of TNM Briefs. And she was like, yeah, okay, fine, right? Like this, I can get behind. And until then, she was like, no, I'm not going to pay. Right? So that was a big milestone for me.